Hey, YouTube family, listen, thanks for checking in today, man. We're actually on the patio in AZ, just having a good time, chilling and relaxing. Remember, this is a YouTube channel for men, ages 8 to 80. We discuss various topics, such as fashion, finance, the criminal justice system, and how to become an alpha male through social intelligence. All right, family, today's video is extremely important, all right? But before we hop into it, please, please make sure you subscribe, share, and hit the notification button so you can receive our new videos. We release a new video every Sunday at 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Please make sure you sit back, relax, and enjoy the content. All right, family, this video today is extremely critical. We're going to talk about the Fifth and Sixth Amendment as it applies to constitutional law. Now, just a disclaimer, I'm not a lawyer. However, I am a criminal justice professor. I've been teaching criminal justice for about 13 years. I do have a bachelor's and master's degree in criminal justice and also a second master's in adult education and training. I give you that information for context so you know exactly who you're talking to, okay? Now, just another side note, family. Earlier this month, we filmed a video discussing ethics within the criminal justice system. We have some great responses, some great views, so please make sure you check out my video on ethics that we produced earlier this month. And we're going to have another video releasing later this month discussing ethics again in the criminal justice system. So please make sure you tune in for that. One more thing, family. In June, we're going to take a break, we're going to take a little vacation, and we're going to resume, kick back up again in July with a totally different topic, social intelligence, from that perspective, reviewing the book, The 48 Laws of Power. All right, family. Now, without further delay, let's hop into the Fifth Amendment for your understanding. The Constitution guarantees that an individual cannot be compelled by the government to provide incriminating information about him or herself. In other words, family, I'm going to keep it very simple for you. You have the right to remain silent. Most people don't understand this perspective and how critical it is. And you know, I've seen different videos or in different criminal justice or crime videos, like the first 48, where an individual would get called to the police station for quote unquote questioning. That person may go down there or visit the police station without a lawyer. That's a huge mistake, family. Wherever you're in a situation, please, please understand, you are protected by the Fifth Amendment. You have the right to remain silent. So please make sure you exercise that, all right? And to just give you another scenario, I'm sure many of you are familiar with the Central Park Five. That's a very unfortunate case I've studied over my 13 years. And one of the greatest mistakes these individuals made, and they didn't know because they were children, they did not remain silent and wait for legal counsel. So again, family, the Fifth Amendment protects you against self-incrimination. You have the right to remain silent, all right? Now, let's transition into another amendment I want to talk about. The Sixth Amendment states, the Sixth Amendment guarantees the right of criminal defendants, including the right to a public trial without unnecessary delay. You have the right to a lawyer. Now, just a little caveat with that, you have the right to a competent lawyer. Your lawyer should be competent. In other words, I've seen cases, specifically Central Park Five, where one of the individual's lawyers were actually sleeping in the courtroom. So you have the right to a competent lawyer. Remember that, family. The right to impartial trial, in other words, right to jury of your peers, and you have the right to face your accuser against any charges against you. Now, the most critical element with this particular Sixth Amendment, I want you to understand, is this. You have the right to a trial, and you have the right to a lawyer. All right, family? So just a quick recap. Fifth Amendment protects you against self-incrimination. You have the right to remain silent. Sixth Amendment, some different caveats with that, but you do have the right to a competent lawyer. All right, family, Thanks again for checking in. Remember, please subscribe and share our channel. And remember, we're going to take June off. We're going on vacation. We're going to start back up in July. All right. Have a good day.